Hi everybody. So I've been playing this new game called Trombone Champ, and if you haven't heard of it, it's kind of like Guitar Hero, but instead of playing a cool instrument like a guitar, you're playing a trombone. And so I've been having a lot of fun with this game actually. It's really creative and innovative. And as a musician, I feel like, as a musician gamer, I feel like it's really hitting the sweet spot for me. And so it's even more impressive too when you find out that it looks like there's only like one person behind the actual game. But having said that, I feel like there's still something missing in the game. And I think it boils down to the fact that, when I play a racing game, it's a lot more fun when you have like a steering wheel and you're sitting in like a fake car. Or if you're playing, like a flight simulator, it's a lot more fun if you have like a flight stick and you feel like you're actually flying a plane. And so my hypothesis here is that if you were playing an actual trombone while playing Trombone Champ, it would be a lot more fun and a lot more accurate. And so what I decided to do was create a Trombone Champ controller for the game. Now, luckily for me, I actually have a lot of novelty instruments and I'm a trumpet player. And so I happen to have this Jupiter soprano trombone just sitting in my closet. And so what this is basically a slide trumpet. It's a trombone, but it's in the key of B flat, which is the same as regular trumpets. And so basically all I need to do is take this and retrofit it to turn it into a controller. So I was looking online at different libraries that I can use to sort of pretend that I'm a mouse. So I found this library that basically turns an ESP32 microcontroller into a mouse. And so that's perfect for me because I actually have a few of those sitting around anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect the ESP32 to a few sensors on this trombone, and then connect that to my computer by Bluetooth so I can actually play the game using my trombone. Okay, so with the trombone and the ESP32, I basically have two problems to solve. One would be the blow problem, and the other is the slide problem. And so let's start with the blow problem. Basically, I didn't want to add a button or, some kind of switch to the trombone to play a sound because that's not how real wind instruments work. And I wanted to keep this experience as close to the real thing as possible. And so I started looking at sensors online for like wind or air sensors. And I found that airflow sensors are just really expensive and don't really make a lot of sense. Sensors, sense. So basically, I found another sensor that looked perfect for the job. And that was an air pressure sensor that had a little port on it so you could stick a hose on it. And so my idea was that I could put the hose to the mouthpiece and then have it run through the entire trombone and out the bell. And then when I blew into it, I could connect a tube to it and then it would sense the air pressure change when I blew into the horn. So this turned out to be not a very good idea because if I put actual tubing into the bell and into the horn, I wouldn't really be able to move the slide very much because the tube would have to move with the slide and it just wouldn't work. So I ended up actually just putting the entire sensor inside the bell and then sealing the whole thing with some saran wrap to make an airtight seal. And actually when the sensor is in there, it kind of glows red when it's on and it gives my trombone kind of a cool cyberpunk feel. So when I measure the ambient air pressure inside of the trombone, it happens to be about 1014 HPAs. And so when I blow into the horn, it goes up, and it goes up by about like 5 or so. And so basically, I just check constantly to see what the pressure in the horn is. And when the pressure goes up, then I can click a mouse. And then when the pressure goes back down, I can release the mouse. And so this is the way that I can control playing the trombone in the game with my actual trombone. So here's a quick demo of the blow to click feature in action. So I have this website open where I can test mouse clicks. And so basically, I can just blow to click, and this one's a kind of a fun one because you can actually see how many times you can click in a second, and so it's actually really responsive. And I can also show another website where it actually shows me holding down the breath, and so as long as I keep blowing, the mouse stays clicked. Okay, so with my blow problem far behind me, we're going to move on to the slide problem. And so the problem with the slide in the video game is that it uses a mouse. But in real life, when you're using a trombone, you're going into first position, and you can't really go like past first position. And so you get some real feedback when you hit the end of the trombone. When you're moving a mouse down and it hits the end of your desktop, the mouse doesn't just stop. And so you've got kind of like this weird drift thing going, where I wanted to actually have it so that the position of the slide controls the absolute position in the video game. And this would actually make it a lot easier to play because you can use muscle memory, which is like what you do when you actually play the trombone. And so to figure that out, I looked at a bunch of distance sensors, and there are a lot of them. There's LiDAR, there's infrared, there's time of flight. I was also thinking you could probably use a gyroscope and just attach it to the slide to actually have it determine how far you've moved it. So to be honest, I just wanted to get this project done as fast as I could. So I found the cheapest time of flight sensor I could find on Amazon.com, which was shipping tomorrow, shipping the next day, and I just bought that one. It ended up being like $7. So I actually attached it to the bell of the trombone, and then I put a piece of cardboard on it so it could bounce the laser off to see how far the laser was away from the initial position. But when I actually hooked it up to my microcontroller, I found that it was giving some pretty inaccurate readings. And so it was kind of bouncing around a lot, even if I wasn't moving the thing. And I was a little bit worried at that point, but I figured I would just hook it up and see what happens.
Okay, so now that everything is hooked up, let's see all the different parts of the Trombone Champ controller. So first and foremost, here is the microcontroller. And so this is the ESP32. And it's connected to this breadboard, which has wires connected to each of the sensors. And I also want to point out that this is not a bomb. This is a trombone game controller. This is not a bomb. So the nice thing about this ESP32 microcontroller is that it actually has this port here, which I can connect to a lithium ion battery, which is right here. And so if I want to, I can actually play this game wirelessly instead of having it plugged in through USB for power. And so on the slide of the trombone, you can see there's this piece of cardboard, and then I have the time of flight distance sensor here, and then I also have the glowing red air pressure sensor in here, which is sealed off by the saran wrap.
Okay, so after all of that work, how well does the trombone controller actually work? Well, I recorded me playing the national anthem in a very heartfelt way, and so I'd like to show you that footage now from the game. Okay, so it looks like the accuracy of the time of flight sensor could be a little bit better. I found that it probably is defective because I don't think that a real product can be that bad. So that's probably my fault for buying a product from Amazon from a manufacturer called Hi-Let Go, which kind of sounds like that's also their QA testing motto. But you know, I think, to be honest, I'm actually really happy with the way that this project turned out. For one thing, the blow sensor actually worked really well, and I was a little bit worried that it wouldn't be responsive enough to actually play a game with it, but it turned out that the response time is really good, even if it goes through Bluetooth into the computer through a sensor from me blowing air into a horn. So I thought that was really neat. And on top of that, I've never used an ESP32 microcontroller to create a fake mouse before, so that was pretty interesting. I might be able to use that in future projects as well. But you know, it's it's easy to say that this is kind of a failure, but I think prototyping kind of, this kind of stuff is an iterative process anyway, so I'm happy to share with you the results, even if they're not the best. And I also thought it was interesting to see how the airtight seal on the horn was not completely airtight, and so when I was blowing through the horn, there's still a little bit of pressure, but there's some air coming out. And so I think I actually used more air blowing the horn when it was, you know, covered up than when I actually play the instrument in real life. And so I think that could add to some fatigue. I think if I was playing this game for more than a minute and a half at a time, I might actually get pretty tired from blowing into the horn just because of all the air that I'm using. So I might try to seal this up a little bit more. And so as far as next steps go, I've already ordered a couple of new sensors. So one is an acoustic distance sensor. And then there's another time-of-flight sensor that I bought from Adafruit, which I think is going to be higher quality than the one I bought from Amazon. So actually, I'll probably end up making a follow-up video to see how well those work. So if you want to see the next video, please go ahead and like and subscribe to my channel. And then, you know, YouTube will tell you next time I actually post something. And I tried to make this video pretty interesting, but also like not have too much detail, so it's really boring. So if you want to know more about some of the processes behind, you know, the way that some of these components work, let me know. If you think that's boring, then you can also let me know. And also, if you actually happen to turn your own trombone into a Trombone Champ controller and it actually works better than mine, please leave me a comment and let me know how you did it. But yeah, aside from that, I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next video, and happy tromboning!